Let's draw the circle, and in it, let's inscribe the square. Now let's say that the area of this blue square is equal to 25 square units. Now let's inscribe the small red square between the bottom side of our big square and the circumference of the circle. What is the area of this small red square? If you want to try this one for yourself, this would be a great time to pause the video and do so. Alright, let's get to the solution. Let's start with the area of the big blue square. Since its value is equal to 25, and we also know that the formula for the area of the square is equal to a squared, we can easily see that a squared is equal to 25, and in our case, that means that a is equal to 5. So the side of our big blue square must be equal to 5. Now let's continue by drawing a diagonal line, and let's mark it as D. Now let's draw the center of the circle. We can easily notice that this center divides our diagonal into two identical segments, which represent the radius of our circle. That means that diagonal D must be equal to 2 times R. And since we are aware that the formula for diagonal of the square is equal to a times square root of 2, we can mix those two together and we get that 2r is equal to a square root of 2. Since we know that a is equal to 5, we can substitute that in and we will get that the radius of our circle is equal to 5 square root of 2 over 2. Now let us draw another radius from the center of the circle to the intersection point between the bottom corner of our red square and the circumference of the circle. Now let's clear the board a little bit and let us draw another line from the center of the circle to the bottom of our square. Let us mark the side of our square as X. Now we can notice that the distance between the center of the circle and the bottom side of our big blue square must be equal to half of the side of the square. And since we already got that the side of our square is equal to 5, we can substitute that value in. And we will get that that value is 5 over 2. Let's also replace the value of r with the 5 square root of 2 over 2. Let us notice that now we have this green right triangle, and let's isolate it for the moment. We can see that it has hypotenuse of 5 square root of 2 over 2. The right leg must be equal to x plus 5 over 2, and the bottom leg must be equal to the half of the side of our small red square, and that is x over 2. Now we will use Pythagorean theorem that states that x over 2 squared plus x plus 5 over 2 squared must be equal to 5 square root of 2 over 2 squared. Now we will solve this equation. Our first term will be equal to x squared over 4. And we can see that in our second term we have the binomial square. Let us remind ourselves that the formula for binomial square states that a plus b squared is equal to a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. So, if we apply this formula in our second term, we will get that that is x squared plus 5x plus 25 over 4, and that is equal to 50 over 4. Now we can lose the fractions by multiplying everything with 4, and we will get the following. Now we will simplify this equation and we will get 5x squared plus 20x minus 25, that is equal to 0. We can notice that we have a common factor of 5, so we will divide everything with 5. And finally we will get that that is x squared plus 4x minus 5, that is equal to 0, and this is classical quadratic equation. We can solve this equation in variety of ways, but for this video I will choose quadratic formula. And just to remind you guys, if we have quadratic equation in a standard form, ax squared plus bx plus c, where a, b and c are constants, we can apply the quadratic formula of minus b plus minus square root of b squared minus 4ac over 2a. We can notice that in our quadratic equation, we have the constant of a that is equal to 1, a constant of b that is equal to 4, and a constant of c that is equal to minus 5. We can substitute those values in our quadratic formula, and we will get the following. Now we will simplify this, and we will simplify things inside the square root even more. And since we know that square root of 36 is equal to 6, we will get the following. From here, we have two possible solutions. The first one will be minus 4 minus 6 over 2, that is minus 10 over 2, so that means that x is equal to minus 5. And the second one is minus 4 plus 6 over 2, that is 2 over 2, so that means that x is equal to 1. Since we know that the side of the square cannot have the negative value, we can disregard the first solution. So that means that the side of our red square must be equal to 1. From here, it is pretty easy to find the area of the square, since the area is equal to x squared. That means that the area is equal to 1 squared, and that means that the area of our red square must be equal to 1 square unit, and this is our solution. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a like and subscribe to the channel. And until next time, see you guys and take care.